Well, hello, welcome to today's coffee break. We are discussing setting up and using recurring journals. So a lot of companies already use recurring journals for their payroll, and we'll go ahead and show that in case you don't. But there are some other uses that I would like to point out to you. So let's go ahead and go to the recurring journals. It's in departments, financial management, general ledger, and you're going to go over here to periodic activities, general ledger, recurring general journals. So let's open that up. And I have a few batches already set up in here. So I have one for American Express. That's a bill that I get every month. And there are different expenses associated that I tend to process with my American Express card. So I've sort of predefined those accounts. I'll show you that. I've also got my payroll journal, which again, I do in this case weekly. And then I've got a few utility batches set up for utilities that need to be paid the first of the month, and then utilities that need to be paid in the middle of the month. So I'm going to go through each of these and sort of show you some of the nuances associated with them. So let's go ahead and open American Express. All right. So basically what I've done is I've already defined this as a recurring journal. And what I've done is I've selected recurring method of variable. So I know that I get this bill every month, but the bill varies as opposed to, let's say, a lease or a car loan. So if you had something that were a lease and it's a fixed amount every month, you would put fixed and then you would put in that dollar amount and it would just sort of stay there. In this case, it's a variable, which means after I post it, it actually zeros out the amount again so that I'm prompted to fill it in every month. You also have the option to post the balance of a GL account. So whatever the balance is as of that date, we'll post that. And then you have reversing fixed, reversing variable, and reversing balance. They work in the same way, but they create a reversing entry the next day. So that's handy for month end if you're trying to do accruals. So you'd post the last day of the month and the reversing entry would take place on the first of the month. So here we go. We got our variable and the recurring frequency for this bill is 1M, so once a month. The posting date is set to 2/28/17. So that will go ahead and roll forward to the following month once I post this. The document type is invoice. And here I have something called the document number. Now the document number has this little code in here, %4. %4 will actually get replaced with the name of the month. So in this case, when I do the posting, the document number will say American Express, February 2018. Let's go ahead and change that to 17. All right. Then I've got my account type vendor, and I've got my American Express account number. And here's the amount. So if you get an invoice from a vendor, we put it in as a credit, right? And then you would go through to each of these expense accounts and just put in the dollar amount for that expense. Obviously, I'm making these up. And I want you to see something down here. As I put in my different amounts, down here the total balance keeps changing. So basically, it's keeping track of the fact that your debits equal your credits. And you'll see it change when I put this last entry in. And now the total balance is zero. So now this batch is actually ready to post. I'm probably going to have a posting date error here because this date hasn't occurred yet. I'm just going to change this. What it does is it keeps track of today's date versus the date you're trying to post in an effort to prevent you from accidentally posting in the future. So you don't want to double up your postings. So I'm just going to cheat a little bit more. Let's make this the end of the month. Okay. And now I'm ready to post. Great. It says I was successful. And here we go. It rolled that date forward to the last day of the next month. And the amount has been cleared out, because it knows it's going to change the next month. Now, if I go over here to navigate and go to ledger entries, I can see that document number got replaced with the name of the month. And I can see the total amount here. And of course, I can navigate and do all those great things that we can do with Navision. So I'm going to go ahead and close this. And then I'm going to take you to the payroll real quick. So the payroll journal, same thing. The only difference here is that instead of a vendor account, I really have a bank account. So I would come in here, and again, it's a recurring method of variable. My frequency is 1 week. Here's my posting date. My document type is blank because this isn't an invoice from a vendor. This is just a GL transaction. And I've included a different sign here, percent two. So percent two will actually get replaced with the number of the week of the year. And I've already set up my different accounts. There we go. We'll just put in some numbers here. Payroll taxes, we'll say we collected 10,000. And then we paid 10,000. All right, and then I put in the amount that came out of the bank. And again, I'm in balance and I can go ahead and post this batch. And now that I have, my posting date has been incremented 1 week and my amounts have cleared out. Let's do one that's a little different here, the utilities. All right, so I have some utilities. These are a little different. So I've got one, postage. I know I'm gonna have a postage amount every month, but I don't know what it's gonna be. Again, same with my phone. I get a phone bill, I just don't know what it's gonna be. And then I have something here that's fixed, like my lease. Now, what's nice about the fixed is I can put in the dollar amount and I can also put an expiration date. So if this is a lease for a year, you can go ahead, put in that dollar amount and you'll just post. You don't have to fill in the amount and it gets incremented. The date gets incremented with each posting. One thing that's a little unique here is the allocated amount. So here's my expense account for my lease and I've allocated 100% of this to this GL account. I could break it out. The reason that's nice is when the year end is up and our lease changes, all I need to do is change it in here and it automatically updates the balancing account with that same amount. Let's look at the phone. So the phone, say we've got a $200 bill, unlikely, but let's look at the allocated amount here. Now what I've done is I have a GL account for my expense, which is phone, and I've got it repeated over and over again, and I've basically broken it out by department. So my dimensions are my different departments within my company. So I can say 80% of this phone bill gets allocated to sales, 15% goes to administration, and 5% goes to production, and it will automatically break out that $200 bill into these different dollar amounts once it's posted. And postage is just a straightforward allocation to one postage account, to my one expense account, and I've allocated one dimension to that particular posting. All right, so those are nice to have set up in advance so that you see if you miss a bill, and you don't have to retype things over and over again. It will post to the vendor's account, and the next time you do your check run, those transactions will pop up as items that need to be paid. That concludes our lesson on using the recurring journals. I hope it helps you out.
Thanks for watching this ArcherPoint video. If you found it helpful, make sure to check out our website and blog at www.archerpoint.com. Additionally, if you have any questions regarding our products, services, or information in this video, feel free to email us at info@archerpoint.com. Thanks.